YouTube, welcome back to Better Better, welcome back to the channel, man. So, man, I know a bunch of you guys have been requesting this one right here, in specifically the Taylor Swift, the Miss Americana documentary, right? Yeah, this is what you guys have been requesting. So, I am finally here to bring it out for you guys today. I don't have Netflix, bro. We going on soap today. It's completely free. I don't pay for no subscription besides like Apple Music or whatnot, bro. Anyways, man, like I said, you guys have been requesting this reaction for such a long time, man. So we are here to finally check it out today. One thing about it is, I think I might have to split this up into two parts. The reason I said that is because I actually got to get to studying. I got tests next week, so I gotta actually like focus up on a test because I did bad on my first. I failed it, bro. Let's be honest here. I failed my first test, bro. So I'm kind of in hot water. So I gotta focus up, and then hopefully I'll be able to pass my test next week. You know what I'm saying? That's just one thing about me. I never start off on a strong foot, bro. I'm always lazy the first part of the semester. You know what I'm saying? Every time the semester starts, I don't start off hot, bro. I really don't. I always start off bad, bro, because I just be lazy. You know what I'm saying? Anyways, man, we just gonna get straight into this thing. Like I said, it is an hour and a half, but we are gonna have to split this up into two parts. So I might try to stop around like the 50-minute mark, maybe the hour mark, and then leave the second part just, you know, shorter. Instead of like doing that with like a real, real long reaction or whatnot. But anyways, man, we just finna go and get straight into this thing, man. But if you guys are new to the channel, man, consider hitting the subscribe button. Please, bro, this is a longer reaction. Consider hitting the subscribe button and make sure you guys hit the like button as well. But we are on the way to 15,000 subscribers. But on that though, hey, let's go ahead and get straight into it, man. Piano.
This is the first one that I started when I was 13, and it says, "My life, my career, my dream, my reality." For a while, I wrote with quill and ink. That was a phase I went through. Like, I had a glass quill with, like, an ink jet. You know, my entire moral code as a kid and now is a need to be thought of as good.
That's dangerous. That's not as dangerous for you.
It was all I wrote about. It was all I wanted. It was the complete and total belief system that I subscribed to as a kid. Do the right thing. Do the good thing. And obviously I'm not a perfect person by any stretch, but overall the main thing that I always tried to be was, like a good girl.
And now to perform the national anthem, a multi-talented performing artist from Reading, Pennsylvania. Please welcome Taylor Swift.
Hey, everybody.
Hi, Taylor.
You know, one of my first memories of country music was when I was 6 years old and my parents took me to see Leanne Rimes in concert.
That's hard! I am happy.
12-year-old.
That just hit you, boy. That just hit you, man. Everybody has this pathway, right? Everybody thinks, boom, your life should happen this way. And I promise you, that's not how it works. Your life's going to happen on your own time, right? So that's just a thing that you got to really, like, pay attention to. Like, everybody flowers don't bloom the exact same way. So, you know what I'm saying? You see people blow up this way. You see people blow up that way and stuff like that. You just got to realize that your pathway is different, though. Everybody's pathway ain't going to be the same. So, you really gotta...
Taylor Swift!
Hey, everybody, I'm Taylor.
I'd been trained to be happy when you get a lot of praise.
Hi, Taylor. See, that's Sony Music right there. Sony is going to listen to her CD today.
I had that praise of, Taylor, you're doing a good job at your work.
Hey, this is Taylor Swift, and thanks for listening to Cat Country 98.1.
You're doing a good job at being a songwriter. You're doing a good job at being a musician. Like, those pats on the head were all I lived for.
No one's going to be watching this because it's my home video, but
right here, look at that. 60 on the Billboard charts right there.
That's crazy, bro. And I'm pretty sure she chart number one right now, every single time, bro.
So fulfilled by approval that that was it.
That looked like the 1989, but it ain't. That's not that 1989, or is it? Ooh. That's the 1989.
I became the person who everyone wanted me to be.
Boy, boy, boy. When I know what it feels like to look at like all my supporters.
My dreams. You should see the things we do. Ooh, in the middle of the night, in my dreams, I know I'm gonna be with you, so I take my time.
Are you ready for it? Reputation, hey. See, reason I shut my head is just because, like, boy, like, you, like, all that screaming is, you know what I'm saying, they there to see her perform, but from the backstage, she could feel it in her feet. Like, I know, like, when a lot of people screaming that way, the vibrations come up under your feet, you start to feel that jump from far away. It's crazy. Boy, that jump is dead, boy.
My God, man.
They don't even know she in the car.
So
that 5%, boy.
Happy. Everybody was so happy watching it.
Nomination day.
Hi.
Good morning.
I've just been like running up and downstairs, like moving things around and packing boxes, like trying not to think about you calling me with Grammy nominations.
I know. Well, I'm trying to get the full list because right now, in the main. Big categories of album, record, song, you are not nominated.
Mm.
Okay, this is good, this is fine.
Yeah, and it's very similar, everything is like this, you know, it's so weird, I said
this is, you know what, like, this is fine, this is, yeah. I just need to make a better record.
Well, Reputation is a great record.
No, I'm making a better record.
Oh, and okay, and then she came in with the Folklore and the Evermore, right? Ooh, boy.
I'm still waiting for the pop, you know, the pop categories. Those should be hitting any second. So do you want me to call you right back when those hit?
Sure.
Okay, I'll call you right back.
Okay, thanks.
Bye.
I don't, is she crying? Nah, she's not crying.
It sounds different than I thought it would on the piano. It almost sounds sadder. Mm-hmm. And I guess it's like the only thing I have. I really have minimal stuff, but it's like. So you say that, like. And then you say that you'll never find another like me.
Nah, she got, bruh. Nah, she got an idea, bruh. She got an idea, you know. What the heck? We in the same. Okay, we in the same thing. I thought we done skipped a song.
I think this is the first single. First verse, and like maybe a lower volume so you can hear what lyrics I'm trying to say. And this is some bullshit on the phone. I never leave well. Never find another like me. Ah. Ooh. I'm the only one of me.
Yeah, there it is.
Baby, that's what's one of me. Ooh. Holy shit. Oh my god, did we just do like this whole verse and chorus?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Everything up to that
boy. The grind time.
Good.
There's so much pressure going into putting new music out. If I don't beat everything I've done prior, it'll be deemed as like a colossal failure.
Maybe first I could talk to you about kind of new album stuff. There's gonna be from 16 to 20 songs on it, is what I'm guessing it's gonna end up at. That's what I was hoping for. That's what I'm guessing it's gonna end up at. That's what I was hoping for. Everybody in music has their own sort of niche specialty thing that they do that, you know, sets them apart from everybody else. And my storytelling is what it is for me. I know that without me writing my own songs, I wouldn't be here. There is an element to my fan base where we feel like we grew up together. I'll be going through something, write the album about it, and then it'll come out and sometimes it'll just coincide with what they're going through.
Mm.
Kind of
family.
Kind of like they're reading my diary.
Yesterday, and it's about a girl who's just different, and I really like it because it's just so happy. So this is called Lucky You.
This song was seriously finished 5 minutes ago. So, you know, I usually have these things memorized, but...
2003? Oh, junk. Hold on. Now, I just thought about that. I was 2 years old. And she with this shit? I thought Taylor was like... Hold up, bruh. Taylor Swift age... 31. Oh, she was born in 1989. Explains 1989 tour. Dang, though. So, when shit... Dang, so she was 11, 3. She was like 14. Dang, bro. I was only 2 years old. 1989. See, I ain't... Okay.
So, let's watch the tide chase the waves into the sand. I wonder if the sad heart feel the warmth of fire.
I started playing guitar and wrote a couple songs, and I've written 150 songs and written every song on this album, so.
You said you were a freshman when you wrote this?
I actually came up with the concept for it in math class my freshman year.
You know, I've had a single out now for about a month.
Yeah!
There's this radio station called KZLA. I want each and every one of you to call them up and tell them you want to hear a song called Tim McGraw by this girl named Taylor Swift. Please.
Set the way my blue eyes shined. Put those Georgia stars to shame that night. I said that's mine.
16-year-old girl released her debut country music album and dreamed of making it big. Well, today that girl is as big as it gets.
In the past year, she has taken Nashville and country music on an unforgettable trip around the world.
She went on to sell more copies than any other artist this year.
That made her the youngest person in history to write and perform a number one country song.
I give myself like 5 seconds a day to be like, yes, this is happening. And then the rest of the day, I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to make it last.
And the Horizon Award goes
Taylor Swift.
I want to thank God and my family for moving to Nashville so that I could do this.
Shoot.
And the fans.
But this joint hit me, boy. This joint got me feeling like happy for it though. I ain't about to cry, you know. If you catch Koala Cam crying, bro, then you just witness history. Cause I don't cry, bro, but. This shot hit me though.
You have changed my life. Thank you so much.
I was riding shotgun with my hair undone in the front seat of this car. He's got a one hand feel on the steering wheel, the other on my heart.
I was in country music and I was doing like a very spectacle type live show.
And I remember thinking,
this feels like a dream, this feels like a dream, this feels like a dream.
We don't have a song.
But when you're living for the approval of strangers, and that is where you derive all of your joy and fulfillment, one bad thing can cause everything to crumble.
And there's only one lady that can actually make an arrival as angelic and as beautiful as this. Ladies
You're
and
right
gentlemen,
on the horse.
Give it up for Taylor Swift.
Oh, Taylor Swift.
Moon Man for Best Female Video goes to Taylor Swift.
Dreamed about what it would be like to maybe win one of these someday, but I never actually thought that would happen. I sing country music, so thank you so much for giving me a chance to win a VMA award.
Yo, Taylor, I'm really happy for you. I'm gonna let you finish, but Beyonce had one of the best videos of all time.
What? For real? Oh, this is when he did this. So they put this up here because I ain't never know the backstory. I just know what y'all told me in comments. You know what I'm saying? Kanye went up on stage and did this. He a sucker.
You finished, but Beyonce had one of the best videos of all time. One of the best videos of all time.
Sucker. And see, that made her feel bad up there. Like, see, that's just... So, you gonna always have people like that, right? Where you got a fire-ass moment going on, right? Fire. Like, the most fire-ass moment you can have in your lifetime. And you just gonna always have somebody that's gonna ruin that one moment. Just that one moment. Dang, though, that's so, like, when the vibe is completely right. You know what I'm saying? And you got that junk going on? Come on, man. Like, what was that gonna do? Like, genuinely thinking, what was that gonna do for you, Mr. Kanye man? You know what I'm saying? Because if you put it in retrospective, it's like, they're not gonna, okay, best music video award goes to Taylor Swift. Oh, Kanye comes up there. Oh, never mind, Taylor. We're gonna take that back. We're gonna give it to Beyonce. That's not how it's gonna work. And even if it did work that way, bro, the reward speech up there wouldn't even be correct, bro. The vibe wouldn't be right. You would get booed off stage instantly. You know what I'm saying? So, that's just not even, I don't know, bro. Let me watch that one more time. That's just ridiculous, bro.
I'm really happy for you. I'm gonna let you finish. But Beyonce had one of the best videos of all time. One of the best videos of all time.
For what, bro?
I was standing on stage and I was really excited because I had just won the award, and then I was really excited because Kanye West was on the stage, and then I wasn't so excited anymore.
And Taylor, are there any hard feelings towards him?
I don't know him and I've never met him, so.
So were you a fan before?
Yeah, it's Kanye West.
Are you still a fan? I take it now.
You know, I don't know him, and I don't want to start anything because I just, you know, I had a great night tonight.
Everyone is talking about this Kanye West Bozo. Thing, aren't they? In case you're lucky enough to have missed it, Kanye West interrupted a young singer named Taylor Swift while she was...
President Obama calling Kanye West a jackass.
Thank you, bro. Thank you, bro. That's not even nothing good. That's not even... And, bro, like... You know, I ain't trying to, like, you know, be, like, rude or anything, bro, but, like, have y'all, like, I really think, like, something's going on with Kanye, bro. Put it this way. Look at this man's new haircut. Check this out. This is ridiculous. This is crazy. Look at this man's haircut, bro. Dead serious. This man went out and got a haircut like this. Look at this. This is a real thing. He called it, like, the lawnmower or something. I would never do no mess like that, bro. That don't take skill. It's something, Kanye, you gotta watch out for him, but he do that, but that's a bozo move, though. Come on, bro.
You 10 or 15 people that he wouldn't have gone up there and taken that mic away from, but he did it with a 17-year-old girl because he could.
It was so echoey in there. At the time, I didn't know they were booing him doing that. I thought that they were booing me. For someone who's built their whole belief system on getting people to clap for you, the whole crowd booing is a pretty formative experience.
That's jacked up, bro. That's jacked up. I went up to the door with you. Air was cold. But something about it felt like home somehow. And I left my scarf there at your sister's house. And you still got it in your drawer, even now.
That was like sort of a catalyst for a lot of psychological paths that I went down. And not all of them were beneficial. Autumn leaves falling down like pieces into place, and I can picture it. It was all fueled by not feeling like I belonged there. I'm only here because I work hard and I'm nice to people. That work ethic, like, thank God I had that work ethic. Like, I can't change what's gonna happen to me, but I can control what I write. Looking at it now, it all seems so simple. We were lying on your couch. I remember. I really just went to this place where I was like, I'm gonna prove myself. I'm gonna make sure people know I deserve to be here.
The New York Times said, by making pop with almost no contemporary references, Miss Swift is aiming somewhere even higher, a mode of timelessness few pop stars even bother aspiring to.
Taylor Swift has done something only the Beatles have done. An album at number one for 6 weeks for four consecutive albums.
One magazine headline said it best. Taylor Swift is the music industry.
Bro, that's jacked up. I'm still thinking about it though, right? Kanye thing was jacked up. That's bro, that's bozo material. Bozo material, bro. Dang that, bro. You got to be, I don't know, bro. So, like I said, bro, Kanye West, I don't know, he do got something going on, but that's just ridiculous what he did on that aspect of things.
That was it. My life had never been better.
That's insane.
I had one album of the year at the Grammys for a second time, which I never thought was a possibility.
Hey, got her handshake.
And I remembered thinking afterward, oh my God, that was all you wanted. Oh God, that was all you wanted. That was all you focused on. You get to the mountaintop and you look around and you're like, oh God, what now?
I want to thank the fans for the last 10 years and the Recording Academy.
I didn't have a partner that I climbed it with that I could like high five. I didn't have anyone I could talk to who could relate to what I was, I had my mom, but I just wondered, shouldn't I have someone that I could call right now?
That's like a real prime example of why your journey to success is so solo. It's so solo. But once you get to the top, it's full of congratulations, bro, because it's literally a gap between people and nobody supporting you to a gap of you getting to the top and everybody supporting you. So you just got to keep the aspect of things, bro.
Do you eat burritos? Do you?
Of course I eat burritos.
Some people don't.
Who doesn't eat burritos?
I didn't ever eat burritos until like 2 years ago. I had never tried. I just had never tried one.
That's the weirdest niche thing.
Yeah.
You
ever do that?
Oh.
The crunch?
No.
That's spicy.
Oh my god.
I'm about to be 29.
29? I remember those days. How do you feel about that?
I mean, yeah, there's a part of me that feels like I'm 57 years old, but then there's a part of me that's like, definitely not ready to have kids, definitely not ready for all this grown-up stuff.
Yeah.
So.
I don't think anybody's ever ready for that stuff. You just figure it out when it happens.
Yeah, when it happens.
I don't really have the luxury of figuring stuff out because my life is planned like in like 2 years ahead of time.
Mm.
Like literally in 2 months, they'll come to me with the dates for the next tour.
Right.
I'm gonna be like, so you'll be at Foxborough Stadium this date, 2020 or whatever year, wow. You know, like,
yeah.
It's so, yeah.
There we go. Incoming. I got it.
Oh, no.
Oh, shoot.
No.
Yeah.
Ha.
I only been on a plane one time. One time out of my lifetime. Just one time. One time only. And that was it. I ain't never been on a plane. There's no need for me to go on a plane.
No, you're not. Your forehead.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. Either that or the lap. I don't know.
Oh,
this
shit.
Is a Rihanna shirt.
Oh, my God. It's all over me.
Mm. Want a bite? It's, what is the advantage?
She did a better job of bracing herself for a takeoff than we did.
It is like traveling with a pony.
But I love her. But I love her.
She's okay. So what you're seeing here is exactly what Mom decided to do when both of her kids were out of the house. She decided to get a third child, like a human-sized dog.
She's actually my cancer dog. After I found that out, I decided to do something I'd always wanted to do, which was get a really big dog. Mm.
That's a good mom.
Yeah, well, that's what it is.
Happy that worked out for you. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. Mm. That's really what it is.
She got cancer several years ago. That has been really hard for me because she's my favorite person.
On the third song where I hadn't gotten it started yet, she goes, come on, Mom, like,
it woke me up from this life where I used to sweat all these things.
Hi, Dad.
How you doing, babe?
But like, do you really care if the internet doesn't like you today? If your mom's sick from her chemo?
Oh, they looked alike.
Gotta be.
Oh, I think that was the dog.
Really prioritize what matters to you. For me, it's my family and my friends.
He's looking good in it right now.
Would you like a glass of red wine or white wine?
Can I do some white wine? Oh, you got the red wine?
No,
that makes me
the recipe, I mean,
a difficult guess.
It's too adult for me,
okay.
To be honest. Yeah.
Oh. And, yes.
I'm gonna get some ice for my wine. You want any?
Yeah. Oh, that's fine. That's honestly just what I wanted.
Yeah.
You're like,
You know, Claire just had a baby.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And like, I went over to see her and...
How is she doing with the motherhood?
Well, she's the best because she's like, just so you know, this is what it is. You feed them, change them, they sleep.
Yeah.
You feed them.
You do it all over.
You change them, they sleep, you feed them,
Like, she's, and I was like, so it's like a Tamagotchi. Like,
oh my God. Like, exactly. Yeah. So I think you would be an excellent mother.
Thanks.
No questions.
That's so good.
I'm gone for a month after this.
Three cats.
Three?
Three cats now.
Three of them, you say? Well, oh, good she luck got a... selling this picture.
That's crazy how they just show up like crazy, though. It's like they be stalking hard, bro.
So this is my front yard.
That's our house. And ain't no way, bruh.
I'm highly aware of the fact that that is not normal. I've learned over the years.
No, that ain't her house. Ain't no way.
It's not good for me to see pictures of myself every day because I have a tendency, and it's only happened a few times, and I'm not in any way proud of it, but I tend to get triggered by something, whether it's a picture of me where I feel like I looked like my tummy was too big, or like someone said that I looked pregnant or something, and that'll just trigger me to just starve a little bit, just stop eating. I thought that I was just like supposed to feel like I was gonna pass out at the end of a show or in the middle of it. I thought that was how it was, and now I realize, no, if you eat food, have energy, get stronger, you can do all these shows and not feel it. Which is
yeah,
really good revelation, because I'm a lot happier with who I am, and I'm happier with, like, I don't care as much if, like, somebody points out that I have gained weight. It's just something that makes my life better. The fact that I'm, you know, I'm a size 6 instead of a size 00. I mean, that wasn't how my body was supposed to be. I just didn't really understand that at the time. I really don't think I knew it. I would have defended it to anyone who said, I'm concerned about you. I was like, what are you talking about? Of course I eat, it's perfectly normal. I just exercise a lot. And I did exercise a lot, but I wasn't eating. And I can't. I don't think you know you're doing that when you're doing it gradually. There's always some standard of beauty that you're not meeting. Because if you're thin enough, then you don't have that ass that everybody wants. But if you have enough weight on you to have an ass, then your stomach isn't flat enough. It's all just fucking impossible. You don't ever say to yourself, like, I've got an eating disorder, but you know you're like making a list of everything you put in your mouth that day, and you know that's probably not right. But then again, there's so many diet blogs that tell you that's what you should do.
Yeah.
This would cause me to go into like a real shame, like hate spiral. This. And like, I caught myself yesterday starting to do it, and I was like, nope, we don't do that anymore. We do not do that anymore, because it's better to think you look fat than to look sick. And we don't do that anymore. And we're changing the channel in our brain, and we're not doing that anymore. That didn't end us up in a good place.
Being our own mentor.
As your career goes like this, the magnifying glass goes like that.
Taylor Swift did not take herself more seriously.
I think that there's plenty of annoying women. I think that Taylor Swift, she is annoying.
She's too good. She's too skinny. It bothers me. All of her model friends. And it's just like, come on.
Lock and load, boys.
Yo, Taylor, you fucked up, Taylor.
We've got a roundup of all the guys that Miss Swiftie has at one point been romantic with. And there are a lot of hotties on this list. Holy what? Date life.
Oh, meet the parents.
He's going through guys like a train.
Can we just get a pic?
What? Dang, bro, y'all come, yeah, bro, the news talking like that? But they got paid that day. I know for a fact, bro, because people click on stuff like that. People want to see people's downfall. That's just something. And it's sad, but that's just how it is. You know, people want to see people downfall. So, like, what the, it's like she been like a train. Like, come on,
bro. And there are a lot of hotties on this list. Holy date life.
Oh, he's coming through. Parents?
She's going through guys like a train.
Can we just get it panned down?
It's beautiful.
I just wanted to show the legs, because as I was telling you ahead of time, you're going to walk home with more than maybe just a trophy tonight. I think lots of men.
I'm not going to walk home with any men tonight.
That's jacked up. That's jacked up. What the world, bruh?
I just wanted to show the legs, because as I was telling you ahead of time, you're going to walk home with more than maybe just a trophy tonight. I think lots of men.
What the
heck? I'm not going to walk home with any men tonight.
Just a trophy tonight. I think lots of men.
I'm not going to walk home with any men tonight.
See, that's just something, like, obviously, okay, being as big as Taylor, you got to show professionalism, right? But when it come down to me, bro, I would literally grab that mic and tell her off. Let's be real. You know me. I keep it 100 with you, so. Ha. You ain't finna say that to me. You know what I'm saying?
We give you the latest can't look away twist in one of America's favorite celebrity feuds.
Kanye West recently dissed Taylor in his new song, Famous.
The song contains a lyric calling Taylor Swift the B word.
I feel like me and Taylor might still have sex. Why? I made that bitch famous.
Kanye had said all along that he got permission. Taylor denied it.
Kim Kardashian released video of Kanye West secretly recording his conversation.
I mean, thanks for being, like, so cool about it.
Oh, thanks. Yeah. Yeah, I really appreciate it. Like, the heads up is so nice.
She posted on Instagram, where in the video is Kanye telling me he was going to call me that biatch in his song?
Swift writing, I would very much like to be excluded from this narrative, one that I have never asked to be a part of since 2009.
I don't buy the story that she was so insulted by that one line. I think she saw an opportunity to be victimized here, and she thought everybody was going to get on her side.
That ain't even cool, bro.
When people decided I was wicked and evil and conniving and not a good person, that was the one that I couldn't really bounce back from, because my whole life was centered around it. Hashtag Taylor Swift is over party was the number one trend on Twitter worldwide.
Dang.
Do you know how many people have to be tweeting that they hate you for that to happen?
Too damn many.
We're people who got into this line of work because we wanted people to like us, because we were intrinsically insecure, because we liked the sound of people clapping because it made us forget about how much we feel like we're not good enough. And I've been doing this for 15 years and I'm tired of it. I'm just tired of the... Just feels like it's more than music now at this point. And just most days I'm like, okay. But then sometimes I'm just like, it just gets loud sometimes.
I had to see something. I was just thinking. I think I'm gonna change this camera. I know we're checking this out, but I think I'm gonna change this camera to my G7X, and it'll bring like better light to the mix. I think that's what I'm gonna do soon, not right now.
When people fall out of love with you, there's nothing you can do to make them change their mind. They just don't love you anymore. I just wanted to disappear. nobody physically saw me for a year. And that was what I thought they wanted.
Dang, bro. A whole year.
The world moves on another day, another drama, drama. But not for me, not for me. All I think about is karma. And then the world moves on, but one thing's for sure. Maybe I got mine, but you'll all get yours.
The reason why that backlash hurt so much was because that used to be all I had.
I never trust a narcissist, but they love me. So I play it like a violin, and I make it look oh so easy. I've been my case for a long time.
I felt really alone. I felt really bitter. I felt, you know, sort of like a wounded animal lashing out.
Is this the end of all the endings? My broken bones are mending with all these nights we're spending upon.
I figured I had to reset everything.
A castle crumbled overnight. Brought a knife to a gunfight. It took the crown, but it's alright. Are calling me one. Nobody's heard from me for months. Doing better than I ever was.
I had to deconstruct an entire belief system for my own personal sanity. I also was falling in love with someone who had a really wonderfully normal, balanced, grounded life.
Wait, was that the guy's hand?
Had a really wonderfully normal, balanced, grounded life. And we decided together that we wanted our relationship to be private.
Call it what you want, yeah, call it what you want to. All my flowers grew back as thorns. Windows boarded up after the storm. It's a fire just to keep me warm. And I know I make the same mistakes every time bridges burn. I never learned, at least I did one thing right. Right. I'm laughing with my love and making pours in the cups. Just I'm like a brother, yeah, you know I did one thing right. Sorry, I was sparking up my darkest night. Call it what you want, call it what you want. So my feelings feel like a bird. Yeah, call it what you want.
I like that song right there.
Even though it was really horrible, I like that happy song. But I wasn't happy in the way that I'd been trained to be happy. It was happiness without anyone else's input. It was just we were happy.
You should take it as a compliment that I got drunk and made fun of the way you talk. You should think about the consequence of your magnetic field being a little too strong. This ain't for the best. My reputation's never been worse, so you must like me for me.
I'm gonna go back to doing my job, and I'm gonna make a record I'm proud of.
We can't make any promises now, can we, babe? But you can make me a dream. Me for me.
I think
it's
really cool.
This ain't for the best. My reputation's never been worse, so you must like me for me.
Can I have it again?
Yeah.
In the middle of the night, in my dreams, that's when I get to be with you. It's so sweet.
Oh, dang, I about to say, I like, what the world? He just went haywire, but then he...
Time to do vocals. What are you doing?
I just look crazy though when it's exposed like that.
I'm trying to ruin my party shoes for vocals.
Good. We've never really gotten a good take without them, have we?
No.
We would jet set Bonnie and Clyde. Oh, till the switch to the other side.
Like a Dylan-y kind of thing.
No surprise.
something.
I'm in a getaway car. And you're in the motel bar. Or like,
yeah, I'm in the getaway car, left you in the motel bar, took the money.
Took the money in the bag and I stole
the money.
Put the money in the bag and I stole the keys. That was the last time you ever saw me.
That was the last time you ever saw me. Driving the getaway car. We were flying, but we never get far. Don't pretend it's such a mystery. Think about the place where you first met me. Riding in a getaway car. There were sirens in the beat of your heart. Should have known I'd be the first to leave.
See, I remember when I first reacted to this song right here, this was like the end of the scene, and I had asked some of you guys, why was she walking like this, like with her arms out like that? But it was something, but I can't remember what you guys had said. It was like something like her, I don't know. So you guys said something, I just...
Big reputation. Yes. You and me, we got this. You look like a Barbie.
Okay.
I'd just like you to be a witness for something special, Miss Taylor Swift.
Oh my God.
I'm going to ask Miss Maybelle Marciano to be my wife.
Oh, for real? That's dope.
Of my love and appreciation for you. Love you.
Wow.
Wait, did she say yeah? I ain't even get.
I got this special token of my love.
Oh, I guess they cut it. Okay.
Love you. Wow.
That's dope.
Oh my
Proposing
God.
In front of Taylor Swift.
I didn't know that was gonna happen at all.
That's dope,
I was
man.
Like, you just like high five.
Thank you.
You guys engaged now? This
yes.
is a, this is a
it's official.
My God, that's amazing. Whoa. Bye guys. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Whoa.
That's insane.
Never find another like me.
Yeah, ooh.
Find another one, see.
Boom.
Never find another like me.
Oh, man. Mm.
Like, I just want, like, little kids to be like, there's no one like me. Like,
that's like the, exactly.
Do you think that you want to stay in L.A. for...
No, actually.
Yeah.
My wife is from Detroit. So we talked about getting the place to test it out. And then fans found it, and I had to leave.
Oh, would they just wait outside?
They would jump the gate and like try to open our
oh,
front door.
Shoot.
Yeah, let's not do that.
That's not okay.
Yeah. There's a difference between I really connect with your lyrics and I'm going
and
to
I
break
want your blood.
In. Yeah. Yeah.
Heck yeah, that's crazy.
Break into my apartment and sleep in my bed a couple months ago.
What?
Didn't like it.
What the I mean oh, my bad. Right. But yeah, that's crazy as hell.
Oh, there it is. There's that middle.
I cannot believe you're even sick. That's amazing. There are stars next to your lines.
Okay, cool. Strike the band up for 1, 2, 3.
Oh, you sound fucking great, man.
You sound amazing.
Ooh. I know I tend to make it about me. I know you never get just what you see. But I will never bore you, baby.
maybe your in your first line should be like, no, I tend to make it about me. Like, like, you know what I mean? Like,
about me.
Like, about me.
Oh, okay, cool. Come on, Brittany, you're blowing it.
You sound amazing. Like, you're making it come alive.
I know I tend to make it about me. I know you never get just what you see, but I will never bore you, baby.
There's a lot of guys out there.
Yes.
Sick.
Oh my God.
Thank you so much.
This is ridiculous.
That's so cool. It sounds so fun.
And you're the
like, it's so
pro-est fun. Pro of all time for doing this.
No way. Oh, man, thank you guys. This is so cool.
This is like, I mean, like I'm, and I'm also really so excited that you're down to do like a massive video.
Oh yeah.
Cause it's not going to be a small one.
Oh, it's going to be so
fun. My idea that I had in the beginning is like, it starts in an apartment, like you and me get in a big fight.
Us two.
I storm out and I'm like,
yes, we come!
And then all of a sudden, like, I like have like a parade happening below.
Amazing.
And like, whatever makes you, you,
yeah.
You know, it's just like, emo kids, theater, dance sequences, La La Land, everything.
Nailed it.
And like,
I didn't even check
like
that one out.
It's like dancers, cats, gay pride, people in country western boots. I start riding a unicorn, like just everything that makes me me.
5, 6, 7, 8.
If you were to split open my imagination, what would come out of it?
I'm sweating now.
Just like me.
I got way too excited.
God.
Okay, guys. I'm too excited about everything. I feel like I'm just...
This is so cool.
I was about to say, I like, dang, she finna go to space? She got an astronaut book bag on, but it was a dog, you know?
Yes.
I ain't never seen nothing like that button before. Oh, it's a cat. Oh, my bad.
Just a curious cat in a big world. I really, really care about my home state, and I know that in this, at this point in time, like, my home state is a huge, hugely important part of this midterm election.
Tennessee's U.S. Senate race figures to be crucial in both parties' efforts to try to control the U.S. Senate after this year.
Marsha Blackburn, a self-described hardcore conservative, proclaims her support for President Trump often.
I know the left calls me a wingnut or a knuckle-dragging conservative, and you know what? I say, that's all right, bring it on.
One of the things that, like, outraged me so much is that she voted against the reauthorization of the Violence Against Women Act, which tries to protect women from stalking, from date rape, from domestic violence. And then obviously it's a no for gay marriage. It's a no for them to have any rights whatsoever. I think I'll be really upset if people think that Tennessee stands for those things.
You've been very secretive about how you vote, what you're voting for.
Well, I mean, I just figure I'm a 22-year-old singer, and, you know, I don't know if people really want to hear my political views. I think they just kind of want to hear me sing songs about breakups and feelings.
Part of the fabric of being a country artist is don't force your politics on people.
That's for
Let
sure,
people
for
live
sure.
Their lives.
Politics is such a controversial topic. You don't talk about that junk. No matter, like, you just don't do it. It's so bad. Just don't talk about that junk. What's another thing that's, like, really bad? I don't know, bro. The cancel stuff is getting real bad recently, bro. You can't say nothing, bro. You can't say nothing without getting canceled, bro. Nothing, bro. Nothing. You just can't.
That is grilled into us.
These three women have been the reigning queens of pop and country music. They're the biggest selling female artists of all time. Nearly 30 million records sold, and even more fans who always used to love their high-spirited style, their music, and their moxie. Well, that racy magazine cover on the stands today pretty much sums up some of the names the Dixie Chicks are being called in America these days. Traitors, the Dixie Sluts, anti-American. All because of one split-second comment aimed at President Bush right before the war with Iraq.
Their opinion is so ignorant.
They don't know what they're talking about.
I think they are the.
This is why you don't talk about that.
Dumbest bimbos, with due respect, I have seen.
These are callow, foolish women who deserve to be slapped around.
Absolutely.
You just don't talk about that, John, bro.
Throughout my whole career, label executives and publishers would just say, don't be like the Dixie Chicks. And I loved the Dixie Chicks. But a nice girl doesn't force their opinions on people. A nice girl smiles and waves and says thank you. A nice girl doesn't make people feel uncomfortable with her views.
It's my right to vote, but it's not my right to tell other people what to do.
Right there, right there, sister. Come on, come on, come on.
I was so obsessed with not getting in trouble that I was like, I'm just not gonna do anything that anyone could say anything about. I'm getting to the point where I can't listen to people telling me, no, stay out of it, stay out of it. Can you not play for 1 second? Because I'm trying to figure out this. I really like what I was doing, but I can't figure out what key it was in. It's like 4 a.m. in the middle of the night. I would be complex. I would be cool. I'll dedicate the field of now. I found someone to commit to. It'll be okay. Maybe it's like, I'm so sick of running as fast as I can, wondering if I'd get much further if I were a man. If I was a man, I was a man. If I was a man, I was a man.
I was a man.
But if I was a man, hey, then I'd be the man. I'd be the man.
I actually really love that.
Yeah.
Really, yeah. Like that a lot.
Do you want to start, maybe if you start a vibe,
yeah,
then this will just write itself.
So exhausting. You just have to be thinking about this shit all the fucking time.
You are kind of doing a constant strategy in your head as to how not to be shamed for something on any given day. But then you get accused of being calculated for having strategy.
Because it's just this, like, it's a lose-lose situation.
Yeah, it's... I mean, I'm good, but it's been a... You sort of do have to twist yourself into a pretzel on a... hourly basis.
Mm-hmm.
Do you like this for a second verse? Lyric, they'd say I hustled, put in the work, instead of shake their heads and question how much of this I deserve, and what was I wearing, or if I was rude, could I be separated from applauding business I could do, applauding when I'd make a move, but this is so well. What's the name of it?
I kind of know what she's going through with that, right? So you know, Taylor does this stuff where, like, she can wake up in the middle of the night and literally had this thought for the song going at the time, right? So she tries to record it, and then the time she actually hits the studio, either the next day or wherever, even though she has it recorded, she's still trying to find the vibe that she had while she was trying to, you know, put this, like, trying to record this up.
Separated from my good ideas and power moves.
Yeah, I like good ideas.
That's it. Dun, dun, dun. Just more movement. That's really cool.
Sick.
This is so fun to write. We drink to the bit in the bottles, to the bitches and models, to the daughters and daughters, to the bees and the bottles, to the night.
That sound gay.
To the bitches and models, to the, do you know, like, how they're like, we'd drink and we'd be popping bottles to the bitches and models to the hoes and the like. Do you know? Cause they get to call us that. Stuff. They get to fucking call us that.
Yeah.
Like.
Yeah.
Taylor Swift, the singer, she goes to court today against a former radio DJ she says once groped her.
Swift says this picture shows the moment Mueller inappropriately grabbed her, putting his hand up her skirt.
What this had happened fuck? To me.
I mean, what
we
the,
told his
what
boss,
the world?
They did an investigation. He got fired. Then he sued me for millions of dollars. So I countersued for $1.
For $1.
You walk into a courtroom, and then there's this person sitting in a swivel chair, staring at you like you did something to him.
The first thing they say to you in court is, why didn't you scream? Why didn't you react quicker? Why didn't you stand further away from him?
Then he has a lawyer get up and just lie.
For real.
There were 7 people who saw him do this, and we had a photo of it happening. I was so angry. I was angry that I had to be there. I was angry that this happens to women. I was angry that people are paid to antagonize victims. I was angry that all the details had been twisted. You don't feel a sense of any victory when you win, because the process is so dehumanizing. This is with 7 witnesses in a photo. What happens when you get raped and it's your word against his?
That's jacked up.
So, I just wanted to, just kind of looking back, this exact day, a year ago, I was not playing a sold out stadium in Tampa. I was in a courtroom in Denver, Colorado. Honestly, I was there for a sexual assault case, and this day a year ago was the day that the jury sided in my favor and said that they believed me. I guess I just think about all the people that weren't believed, and the people who haven't been believed, or the people who are afraid to speak up because they think they won't be believed. And I just wanted to say that, I just wanted to say I'm sorry to anyone who ever wasn't believed, because I don't know what turn my life would have taken if people didn't believe me when I said that something had happened to me.
Hi, Keith. Like, if people didn't catch that jump, you would have.
The drought was the very worst. When the flowers that we'd grown together died of thirst. It was months and months of back and forth. Hung my head as I lost the war, and the sky turned black like a perfect storm. The rain. Finally breathe, and by morning
and that song Reputation, and we gonna check that out soon, thanks, boy. All right, man. Look, that's a oh, John. Hold up, now. My ass popping up. Hey, hey, hey. Hold up, now. Hey, hold up, now. Pause, now. Pause. Nah, shoot. All right, we're stopping directly at an hour. Means tomorrow we got 25 minutes left to watch. This is absolutely interesting. I'm getting to know a lot more about her. And I'm absolutely enjoying this documentary so far, man. Anyways, man, that's gonna do it for the reaction, man. Like I said, just come back tomorrow and we will finish out part two. But if you guys did enjoy, and if you guys did stay to the end, bro, you're a legend. Good God. This is an hour and 11 minutes, right? Bro, if you stay to the end, you're a legend, man. Anyways, man, other than that, though, hey, Speedball Quality Cam or Cameraman, I'll see you guys tomorrow, man. Peace out. Love you guys.